NASA says it's on schedule for a 2017 unmanned test flight of its biggest rocket yet. As private space taxis have taken the place of the traditional space shuttle, NASA has shifted its focus to flights deeper into the solar system through its new heavy-lift launch vehicle, the Space Launch System. According to Gizmag, the SLS is expected to have an initial launch capacity of 70 metric tons, or roughly 40 SUVs. Later models will be able to carry nearly twice as much. The lifting ability of the rocket will make a big difference in transit times. Space.com writes, it would also allow NASA to send probes directly to planets like Jupiter without the lengthy gravity assist swings by Venus and Earth, as have been undertaken for missions launched by less powerful rockets. Transit times to the giant planet would be cut down to about 3 years. The program's engineers hope to conduct the first unmanned flight in 2021 and utilize the SLS to conduct a manned mission to a nearby asteroid by 2025, then take a crew to Mars in the 2030s. NASA will receive about $17 billion in funding to work with during 2014, as NASA Administrator Charles Bolden requested in April. But it will need another $18 billion over the next 5 years for the SLS alone to stay on schedule. And to do so, it's already started cutting into other parts of its budget. NASA's budget proposal this year included a 20% reduction to its planetary science program from 2012 funding levels. The 2017 SLS test flight is planned to go beyond lunar orbit. For Newsy, I'm Elizabeth Hagedorn.